that I get my dots in the right places, because character assassination is out there in the wings just waiting for me to screw up. So now back to the, okay, if you remember around the time when we had some of the people from the Pentagon and the intelligence community coming forward, trying to tell the American
people. Keep it right there. I'm sorry. We had to go to break. Oh, the breaks are all at the end and the start of the hours. We're back in 60, 70 seconds. We'll go right to you. Tosh Plumlee's our guest. Tell friends and family, tune in. This is a huge whistleblowing.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system, or call 1-888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, I'm going right to Tosh Plumlee in this short segment, giving him the floor. Sorry to get interrupted by the breaks. Long segment coming up. Huge whistleblower on so many fronts. Please continue where you were getting to in the intelligence community in Benghazi.
Okay, now, if you noticed back around the time, we had a couple of generals that were getting ready to talk about this out of channels. Administration jumped them. I think those guys were asked for early retirement. A couple of people up there, colonels and some birds and different ones were talking about this and was warned to shut up. It could affect their careers. Some of them have actually retired and come out and now have talked about what we're talking about here. So we have the Pentagon and intelligence gathering, getting up and being blocked. And then the main thing was the letters that Stevenson wrote to the State Department, basically asking what to do. This is what we found. This is what Iraqi intelligence is telling us is going on. What do we do? Now, that was the reason that I devised the 11 Benghazi questions, which you posted over a year ago, or about that a year ago, on your program. And one of those questions specifically stated, will someday we be fighting our U.S. weapons on some foreign battlefield? Simple yes or no. To anyone, Senate on both sides of the aisle, that would answer simple yes or no. The 11 questions were based upon the same documentation that Ambassador Stevens had written, asking the State Department and others in the administration what to do. That jeopardized the official position of this government. And so therefore, those documents had to be sanitized. Those documents had to be withheld because it would show an illegal operation of a gun running situation, and the weapons were not being monitored and allowed to get into the wrong hands. Now, if this was purpose or not, I have no way of knowing. The fact remains that U.S. weapons, and I'm talking about tanks, Humvees, launchers, missiles, over $6 billion, and weapons, just that I know about, that I've been told from sources out of the Pentagon. The reason that I was contacted by NATO is they don't know what to do. Mainstream media does not touch it because they've been infiltrated through the old, what I call the old Mockingbird Project, and I know, Alex, you know what I'm talking about. were infiltration of CIA operatives into the as journalists,
and the worst, and the worst of the political class that just absolutely are totally incompetent. They'll just lie. That's who they stick in there.
Well, that's right. And then some of this, when we get into where they say this is a conspiracy on the part of this administration and elements within, sometimes I disagree with that. What I see is total incompetence. These people up there have demonstrated, and I use that word over and over and over, they've demonstrated to me that they are totally incompetent to even run this country. And that is shown by the people that they put in that are not qualified to put in these strategic positions and infiltrate those people into the intelligence community. And then they sit and suck up the information if it's not in line with administrative policy. So it's not an intelligence community failure. It is a political failure.
That's right. The political groups are in control, and that's why they can just lie to people on so many fronts now, is because we literally have political state-run media. Tosh, stay there. We've got huge breaking news that just went live at Infowars.com. The White House emergency alert has interrupted television viewers across the United States with a message of Ebola emergency. This is unbelievable. The video is on Infowars.com. This is not broken in the news yet. We are breaking it as far as I know. And it says, remain calm and don't use your phones during the Ebola outbreak. This looks like a false start, talking about incompetence. They're getting ready for something big.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Alert. Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
You let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
It's a popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos. Read the information there compiled. And for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
You are listening to an
InfoWars.com Frontline Report. It's Alex Jones.
I was told about 18 years ago by an engineer who managed 10 local stations as the head engineer, had a couple engineers under him, that he'd been brought into meetings with the Texas Association of Broadcasters and the FCC, and they told him, in the future, we're going to take over the phones, the radio, the TV, we're going to have things called smartphones, we're going to roll these out. And he was the engineer representing the Texas Association of Broadcasters in the meeting. His name was Kevin Stone. He's dead now. And he gave me the documents. It said not for distribution. It was all FEMA. I shot video of it. I put it in a film. And I won't get into the whole story because we've got Tosh Plumlee here. But we always knew when they're getting ready to really drop the hammer, this stuff's been in now for about 15 years completely, that they would start using it and getting you accustomed to it. Forced video messages on your phone from the president. Forced video messages on radio and TV. Nationwide, viewers from Austin, Texas, to Atlanta, Georgia, to Detroit, Michigan, North Carolina, you name it, an emergency alert took over with text saying that during emergencies, do not use your phones. And it caused panic and warned them not to use their phones. And amidst all the Ebola crisis, that's how it prompted confusion, given the highlighted tensions over Ebola. That's what they're doing. And my phone will now turn on. It's really a computer. Will turn on, and there'll be alerts from the president on it. So I have to turn it off and put it in another room to sleep. So it starts out with floods and things that sound reasonable, and a missing old lady or whatever, missing kidnapped kid, and turns into this. Talk about Operation Mockingbird, what Tosh Plumlee was getting at, CIA government infiltration, political infiltration, where they just put, I mean, look at CNN or Fox or MSNBC or any of them. Half the people are former administration PR flacks. And then they legalized the CIA engaging in domestic propaganda this year. I mean, they could legalize murder, still murder. Tosh Plumlee, I want you now in the time you've got to run over finishing up on Benghazi, and then you wanted to get into Kill the Messenger, Gary Webb. You were one of his main sources. You were Congress's source. Everything you talked about on that's been vetted and confirmed. And it's a testament to you doing the right thing and then continuing to do contractor work, because there are a lot of good people in the system. And as you pointed out, most of the good intel I get fighting the tyranny is from the Army. And I'm not lionizing the Army, but it was Fletcher Prouty at the Army that exposed the JFK thing. I know you were very intimately involved in those operations, Bay of Pigs, you name it, not just on the aircraft, but on the ground. A lot of that's highly classified. You say you're going to break your silence in Dallas on the anniversary coming up. But I think for your safety, let's just spill as much guts here as possible, including what you told me about Mexico and ISIS. We just, because I don't like knowing that. The crew doesn't like knowing it. Can we please just get as much as you told us out there so they don't come kill us all?
Well, okay, sometime back, am I on now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sometime back, there was information came, you know, go back to the Mexico thing with Task Force 7 out of Fort Bliss, Texas, which Bill Conroy, Narco News, covered very, this goes back to 2010, of weapons going across the border. That led into the Fast and Furious, which they tried to blame on mom-and-pop drugstore gun sales and illegal stuff. Then later, these weapons began to show up that could not be traced back to mom-and-pop gun stores, but they came back through the direct commercial sales program, which this administration's supposed to have been monitoring to make sure that those weapons did not get into the wrong hands. However, those particular weapons ended up in this Zeta's hands and other gangs that later came into cartels. And then as a result of all that, during that period of time, over 80,000 people were killed inside Mexico. Mainstream media did not cover any of that. Our neighbor next door and their drug war and war that was going on with the cartels down there did not cover that. Bill Conroy, Narco News, and also my friends at SalemNews.com, they did cover it. And then also OC Weekly up in who Nick wrote the book about Kill the Messenger, I believe. And